So today after work, I am leading a ladies' trip to one of my favorite caves over in the Pelham Valley. So come along and join us as we go caving after work today. Like and subscribe for more caving content in the heart of TAG, known as Tennessee, Alabama, and Georgia. It's too dark for video out here already. But here we are, us ladies, getting ready to go caving after work. So this is where we're going to put on our life vests. Because right beyond that right there is a swim. All right, so we just swam through that passage and we've dropped our life vests and we're going to keep going in the cave. You need a third rock. She said, I'm not that good. Look how that came off the ceiling a long time ago. Yeah, that's definitely a water line. You can see the difference in the color, like where mud was deposited. See how pretty this cave is? Look at all these formations. Okay, so there is another low crawl that we've got to go through right here. So this passage is about 4 feet tall with about maybe 2.5 to 3 feet of water. Crayfish. Some people say crawfish or crawl. Look at all these draperies in here. So check out this formation right there. Look at how that's growing down and then sideways and then turns into a bulb. Yeah. It's really, really tall. That's probably 10 foot tall. Pretty big. at all these formations in this cave. Just everywhere. He's dead. Holy crap. Oh my God, it's a crayfish from outside, but he's rotting in the water.
It's what?
Rotting. I guess it's like some kind of mold under the water. That's really cool how it's molding under the water. Oh, look, there's one.
Oh.
There's another crayfish right there.
He's like getting away from my food.
Oh, I guarantee they're eating him.
Oh, yeah.
Again, in caving, we call it a crayfish. Not a crawfish, not a crawdad. So for scale, that little guy right there is probably about an inch long. He's moving so fast. Oh, I see him right there in the middle. There he is.
That's a sculpin. Oh, there's two.
No. Oh, no, that's not a sculpin over there. No. I don't think either one of them are a sculpin.
That wasn't a sculpin?
No, I don't think either one of them are. That's a sculpin. And there's another sculpin. So that's what's called a broomstick. And it's just forming from water dripping from the ceiling. And it's very fragile because it's in this sand and gravel. So you don't want to get near anything like that because it could break pretty easy. So that's pretty cool. Piece of breakdown fell. And then this formation started forming over it. So there is a tiny, tiny little cave beetle. Super, super small. This really pretty bell type formation with flowstone on it. It's got some rimstone dams over here. It's what's called a rimstone dam. Seal in there. Such a pretty cave. Looks like some iron deposits here. Really cool. This is chert. All this dark stuff you see on the ceiling is chert. And then you've got all these formations in here. Turn my light down just a little bit. Okay, so I just noticed something really cool. It's a colony of coral here in the ceiling. Really nice fossil. Really, really nice. Put my hand up there for scale. Check that out. are some more fossils. Those look like some horn corals. So here are some more fossils. And then you've got all these right here. And then the other big ones right there that I just showed you. So, not gonna touch them, but really cool fossils. Here's some more fossils. Some type of coral. We're just oohing and aahing over all these fossils.
Some rock that grows in that shape. Hey, what did you see? I can't remember what
it's. It's a nice little cluster there. There's just so many formations in this cave. So this is a pretty cool fossil. So we're not sure what kind of fossil this is. Really cool. Yeah, it could be some type of fin. Pretty cool. So we are back at our life vest, and we're going to put those on so we can swim back out of the cave. So I just came through the swim, and I'm waiting on Angel and Jenny so we can show you guys them coming out of it. You can hear them coming through. Light is blinking because my battery's dying, but that's okay. I got a backup. might not want to stop here.
Okay.
I'm like perched on a ledge.
Yeah.
Until you can touch.
Keep going.
Then here comes Jenny. You can go around that way, either way. Just made it out of the cave, waiting on Angel and Jenny to climb out.
Yeah, I just face planted into my backpack. I think it was easier when I didn't have my life jacket in my backpack.
At least it's soft, right?
Yeah. Softer than a rock. Almost there.
Okay.
Thank you, Callie.
You're welcome.
Woo, good cave. Okay.
Okay, so we've made it back to the truck. We're gonna get out of these wet clothes and get on home and go to work tomorrow. Thanks for joining us. Like and subscribe for more Caving in Tennessee.